The Wimpei Audiobook Series. Coiling Dragon, aka Panlong, by I Eat Tomatoes. Book 3, Mountain Range of Magical Beasts, Chapter 23, Her Name Was Alice, Part 1. On the return journey, the magical beasts which Linley encountered grew progressively weaker. By the time Linley stepped into the outer regions, all of the monsters he encountered were of the third and fourth ranks. They posed no threat to him at all. But despite this, Linley didn't dare to relax his vigilance. Dowering Coward traveled alongside Linley, but in his mind, Dowering Coward was worrying. Right now, Linley carried within him a steady, stable presence, but when he made his move, he showed no mercy at all. His eyes also carried within them a cold, forbidding aura. Dowering Coward still remembered how, when he first entered the mountain range of magical beasts, Linley's eyes were filled with sincerity. He was a very trusting person. After hesitating for a while, Dowering Coward mentally spoke to Linley. Linley. Making his way through the mountains, Linley turned his head to look questioningly at Dowering Coward. Grandpa Dowering, what is it? Dowering Coward nodded as he spoke seriously. Linley, before entering the mountain range of magical beasts, I had warned you that people were not to be easily trusted, as people's intentions are not easily understood. I told you to be wary of others, to have a cautious mind. Linley nodded. Grandpa Dowering, your words were very correct. One really cannot easily trust others. If I had listened to Grandpa Dowering's words early on, my chest most likely wouldn't have this knife scar. Dowering Coward shook his head. Although one cannot easily trust others, one also cannot be overcautious. The way you are currently, how will you be able to interact with people in the future? Remember, you can't be too cold and callous towards others, even if you can't be overly trusting either. Trust is something which is built up through a long period of time. Do not easily trust the words of others. Linley was very smart. Both at home and at the Ernst Institute, he had read many books. Upon hearing Dowering Coward's words, he somewhat understood. But the merciless life he had experienced over these past 2 months, the human cruelty he had witnessed and experienced, was something he had seen so clearly. For him to trust people again would be very hard. Dowering Coward, I understand. Linley nodded. Dowering Coward secretly sighed, but at the same time, he was also happy. It's a good thing that Linley has this little shadow mouse, Bebe, for a companion, as well as those friends of his at the Ernst Institute. At least he shouldn't become excessively unfeeling. Dowering Coward could still remember how, thousands of years ago, when the Poent Empire was still around, another saint-level combatant of the Poent Empire who also dressed in white. That white-robed man was a famous sword saint, and he was also an extremely proud, reclusive person. Grandpa Dowering, when Father sees all of these Magi Psi cores, what do you think his reaction will be? Linley suddenly looked at Dowering Coward, smiling as he asked the question. At this moment, Linley's eyes were filled with eagerness for his father's praise. He looked just like a kid who had just performed stellarly on a test and was awaiting his father's praise. Linley, are you planning to give all of this money to your father? Dowering Coward asked with a smile. Linley nodded. Of course. These Magi Psi cores are worth around 70,000 gold coins. All I need is enough to feed myself. A few dozen coins each year is enough. But father needs to manage all of our clan's affairs, and also provide for warden's tuition. Of course I'll give these magi side cores to father. Lily didn't want to personally sell these magi side cores. After all, in terms of buying and selling, he had no experience at all. He probably wouldn't even know if he got cheated. Haha, I trust your father will be so excited that he'll be jumping up and down, Dowering Coward said, laughing loudly. Lily couldn't help but grin as well. He immediately sped up the pace on his journey back. By now, Lily couldn't even be bothered to kill magical beasts of the third and fourth ranks. He quickly made his way through the mountains. When he arrived next to a small creek, he paused as he heard the furious bellows of a magical beast, intermixed with the shouts of humans engaged in battle with it. HRM? If they dare come to the mountain range of magical beasts, they must be at least combatants of the fifth rank. But in the surrounding areas, the local beasts are of the third or fourth ranks at most. How could the battle sound so prolonged and frenetic? Lily was rather curious. Within the inner areas of the mountain range of magical beasts, where beasts of the fifth, sixth, and sometimes even the seventh rank would appear, there would often be many frantic battles. But in the outer areas, this was quite rare. Battles would generally end extremely quickly. With a jump, Lily leapt 7 to 8 meters up. Landing on a tree, he began tree walking his way towards the scene of the battle. Upon arriving, Lily surveyed the battle from his position on the tree. He saw that there were 2 young men and 2 young women engaged in a bloody battle with a bloodthirsty war pig. One of the youths, wearing a white armor, was shouting out loudly while directing the course of battle. "Second bro, don't run around so wildly. Protect Alice. I'll draw this stupid pig's attention away. Naya, don't panic, aim your arrows at its vitals." These 4 people clearly were very inexperienced. Upon encountering danger, they had panicked. Only the leader wearing the white armor seemed a bit more capable. These 4 really have some guts. That youngster in white armor should be a warrior of the fifth rank, while the other 3 are just combatants of the fourth rank at best. Lily shook his head. Those other 3 really were daring, to come here without even having reached the fifth rank. A red-haired youngster began to shout frantically, "Big brother Kalen Kalan, didn't you say that the outer regions only had magical beasts of the third or fourth ranks? This is a magical beast of the fifth rank." The leader of the group of 4, the fifth ranked warrior Kalen, also felt helpless. As a warrior of the fifth rank, it shouldn't have been a dangerous affair for him to bring a number of friends to the outer regions of the mountain range of magical beasts. But he didn't expect to run into a magical beast of the fifth rank. Whoosh! More than 10 earthen spears suddenly erupted from the ground beneath the war pig, and 3 of them even pierced into the war pig's body, but they were all broken and shattered by the war pig's tough hide. Roar! The bloodthirsty war pig immediately turned its enraged attention upon the only magus in the group, before charging forward at the magus rapidly. The war pig's charge was truly too fearsome, and what's more, flicks of flame could be seen coming from its nostrils. Immediately, it caused the remaining youngster to panic. Run! Alice, quick! Dodge! Kalen shouted loudly. The girl named Alice had a head full of long, golden hair and a pair of hazy eyes. Seeing the danger, Alice too tried to flee in panic, but the bloodthirsty war pig was a magical beast of the fifth rank, after all. Although it was not very intelligent, it was much smarter than a normal animal. The bloodthirsty war pig chased after Alice. Seeing the war pig charge after her, Alice was going to flee, but as she did, she slipped and tripped on a vine and fell face forward into the ground. Turning her head, she saw the furious eyes of the war pig draw closer and closer to her. Based on Alice's weak physical conditioning, the bloodthirsty war pig probably was capable of killing her with just one stomp. Alice was struck dumb with terror. The other two boys and the girl were also stupefied, not knowing what to do. There was no way they could rescue her in time. "Alice!" The youngster called Kalen shouted loudly with anguish. Although he was a warrior of the fifth rank, he simply didn't have enough experience. Rumble! 7 or 8 sharp earthen spears suddenly jutted out of the ground. Although the bloodthirsty war pig, a magical beast of the fifth rank, did have thick skin, 2 of the spears still managed to penetrate its thick skin and into its flesh, causing fresh blood to flow from the wound. But alas! The earthen spears only pierced its flesh. They didn't actually cause any injury to its vitals or organs. Grrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrrr Swish! A black dagger suddenly fell down from above, piercing into the war pig's eye like a bolt of lightning. The war pig's eyeball exploded, and the black dagger penetrated directly into the war pig's brain. Agonized, the war pig's entire body shuddered as it collapsed. Shortly afterwards, it no longer moved. Kaelin, Naya, and Alice were all so terrified, their hearts almost leapt out of their bodies. They watched as a powerfully built young warrior dressed in blue used a knife to extract the magi side core of the war pig in a very practiced manner, and then turned to leave. But Kaelin was the first amongst the four to recover, and he immediately shouted out, "Friend, please stay." End of chapter 23. Continue to book 3, chapter 24. Thank you for listening the audiobook series by Winpei. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for the new updates of audiobooks and games reviews. Love and peace. Winpei.